In this sports Photoshop tutorial, we will design this sign graphic for any sports team. The first step is to create our background. This can be done by selecting the rectangle tool on the toolbar, and we will click and drag across our canvas. Now hit the fill button and select the color wheel. This will allow you to select any color that you want, and we're going to match it to our sports team. So for example, I'm going to use the Illinois orange for my background color. We can now add a layer above our rectangle. Select the pink brush and make sure your hardness is going to be set to 0. Now you can paint black onto the orange, and then we can change the blend mode of this layer and it creates a different shade of orange on your background. The blend mode that we'll change to is called soft light. Step 2, we will insert our player image. This can be done by clicking and dragging from Google or going up to File, Place Embedded, and then selecting your image. Now hit the quick selection tool and press select subject. After you hit the mask button, it will cut out your subject. We can see there are parts of our subject that were not masked properly. You're going to want to select the mask and then click on your paintbrush on the toolbar and make sure that black is the color selected. And now you can erase the areas that the quick selection tool had missed. All right, cool. So after we have our subject cut out, let's enhance the look. Go up to Filter and go into Camera Raw Filter. We're going to add Exposure, Contrast, and Vibrance, and we're going to decrease the blacks. What this is going to do, it's going to make your subject look a little bit lighter, and at the same time, it's going to increase the colors within your subject. You can see this in the before, and here's the after. The next step is to add shadows to our player image. Duplicate your player image and then create a blank layer directly above. Go up to Edit, Fill, and we're going to fill this layer with black. Now right click or control click and create a clipping mask. Select your player image and then select the Move tool on the toolbar. And you can now with your arrow keys move the shadow to the right of your player image. The shadow is too strong, so what we're going to have to do is blur it. We can do this by going up to Filter and then going into Blur and selecting Gaussian Blur. We want to keep the blur around the 20 to 30 range, and then you can reduce the opacity to give it less of an effect. We next can insert our backboard. A link to this, as well as the entire PSD from today's video, and all the effects and overlays that I'm going to use within the video, will be in the description below. For this part, essentially what I did is I filled the backboard with all different types of fonts with the exact same word. By going up to Window and then selecting Character, you can change the distance between the letters inside each font. I sped this part up, but I'm going to go through and click through all the different fonts that I used inside the backboard. In order to group all the fonts together into one folder, select the first font and then scroll down to the last font. Hold Shift and select that last font. This is going to highlight all the fonts used within your backboard. You can hit the folder button in order to group them together. Once you've done that, right click on the folder layer and we're going to duplicate this layer. Right click again on your layer and we're going to now turn this layer into a smart object. Make sure your smart object layer is below the folder layer. Now select the smart object layer and with your arrow keys, you can arrow key down and it will move the bottom backboard below the top backboard. This is gonna look a little bit funky to start, but stick with me here. Go up to Image, Adjustments, and then Hue and Saturation. You're gonna drag the lightness slider all the way to the left. What this is gonna do, it's gonna create your shadow layer. Now we again can go up to Filter, Blur, and create a Gaussian Blur. And then boom, we got both our backboard and our player layer done. Now we can add different text to our graphic. For this one, I wanted to implement some type of signature. So I created a place for my subject to sign, and then what I did is I inserted a script font. So now it's gonna look like my subject signed on the line. The font that I use for this is called Creation Demo. All the resources needed to create this exact design is gonna be in the description below on my Patreon. Remember, subscribers to the Patreon are gonna have access to all my PSDs from all my YouTube videos, as well as access to a monthly graphics pack where you are gonna get free overlays and fonts to use in your own designs. The font of the X is called Beyond the Mountains. And for the word signed, it's called Tactic Sans. And obviously, this graphic is customizable, so you can also change the word signed to committed or anything that you guys want. A small detail that may go unnoticed to some is the bevel on the letters signed. Go into the Effects tab and select Bevel and Emboss. You can see the slight effect that it creates on my text. This is what it looks like before, and here's the after. All right, this is the most important part of the design. Insert your program's logo, and something you can do is match the colors to the background. This is pretty easy. It can be done by going up to Image Adjustments and then selecting Hue and Saturation. But the real effect we're trying to create is going to be going up to Blur and selecting Radial Blur. What this does is it creates a blur on the outside of your logo. I try to keep the blur amount to under 10, but it could be different for a different logo. You can duplicate this layer and place it all over your graphic, just like I did. You now can add different overlays that can be found in different designers' graphics packs to create different effects on your design. And after we've done that, you should have something that looks like this. If you enjoyed today's video, leave a sub for me, leave a like, and as always, have a good one. Stay great.